I like board games, tabletop games, whatever. And if you have access to a 3D printer, there's no reason for the fun to ever end. There is a ton of great board game projects already available out there. Dutch Mogul of Ill-Gotten Games has made a few you should check out, like the amazing Pocket Tactics or Breach, and he's got a ton of them. If you're into D&D, there's a ton of 3D printable resources for you. And I've even made a few, like my classic TARDIS run, and I've got a new one to show you today, Pasture. It's a game of goats and sheep where you try to wool the world. Wool, as in sheep's wool. Okay, brace yourself, because I'm going to ram in as many livestock puns as I can. You mad, bro? Pasture is the name of the game. I started with a little-known game by a prolific game designer, Sid Saxton, but I added my own twist. In this version, the board is a little smaller, and you can bank unused movement points to unleash on future moves. Both the sheep and the goats want to get to the other side of this mountain range because they hear the grass is greener. Or maybe the sheep just need to get a haircut and want to go to the baba shop? Whatever the motivation, they both have to cross this hilly terrain, and they both want to be the first to do it. The rules are ridiculously fair. For instance, except for the first move, whenever a player rolls their dice, they get movement points equal to their dice plus their opponent's last roll. How brilliant is that? A bad roll is a bad roll for both players, and a good roll is good for both players. And since you're both covering the same terrain, it's not like anyone has an advantage in this game. When I said this game was ridiculously fair, I wasn't kidding. The original Cross Currents game used dominoes to build the board. Movement points are spent to move from one block to another based on the difference between the numbers on both of those squares. This made certain movements more costly, encouraging players to find cheaper routes to where they're trying to go. In my version, I represented this with altitude. Having to move up or down a steep incline might explain why certain moves are more or less costly. Next, I tried to think, why would we have a group trying to cross a mountain range like this? I came up with the Billy Goats Gruff. They were trying to get to the pasture beyond, and some elements of that idea can still be found in this game, with one of the sides being goats, and I even made one of the pieces a bridge with a little troll underneath it. And since the story of the Billy Goats Gruff began in Norway, I looked for some traditional Norwegian clothing to dress my anthropomorphized goats in. I found this illustration of a traditional Norwegian farmer, which I can't believe anyone ever worked a farm dressed like that. But never mind, it inspired the look of the goats. Come to think of it, I should think about redesigning this so that he can have that really baller hat that the guy's got on. It's beautiful. Now, on the other side, I went with sheep and also found an illustration of a Norwegian milkmaid carrying her milking bucket and a horn that she uses to call the goats with. She was wearing a vest, and I found the idea of a sheep wearing a vest with their wool popping out of the armholes. I found this idea so funny that I just had to make it happen. The wool on this model is actually procedurally generated with a displacement map of randomly generated texture, so basically I didn't need to model anything to get this puffy wool, which saved a lot of time. But whenever you use procedural maps, it does sometimes cause additional problems when the wool wasn't going where I wanted it to. But that's okay, it all worked out in the end because I goat skills. I have to admit, though, it is super satisfying getting something like this rigged and posing it and seeing it just move just right on the screen. Yes, these models are rigged, so I could make a bunch of different poses for them, but these poses were specifically chosen to be 3D printable with minimal or no supports, because honestly, supports get my goat. Because each of the models and all of the pieces in this game are pretty much unique, you could print this entire set in just one color. Or you can get fancy with it and change filament for each side, or you could go for the full effect and change the filaments at different layers to give the board this really cool multi-tiered look and to give the entire map kind of like a topographical effect. It's up to you how much work you want to do for this game. Now, if you'd like to get this game, it's available as a free download at 3dpprofessor.com/shop. And while you're there, check out the Filament of the Month Club, check out the low poly dinos, which are available to purchase there. And in the month of January, low poly dinos on sale for you guys. So it's a great time to pick it up if you miss the opportunity to get them during the Kickstarter. And hey, quick tip. Packaging these games is always difficult, making or finding the right box for it. I find the best solution is cheap plastic food storage containers. They come in all sizes and you can even decorate it. In this case, I put the rules right there on top. Isn't that clever? I feel like I need one more joke to end this with, but I've got nothing to go in here. I'm sorry. I feel so sheepish. Before this video ends, some of you might notice that my old Replicator 1 is no longer sitting here on my desk and that I've switched it out for the WeDo. It's not that I particularly love the WeDo. I do. It's great, super functional, and I considered bringing it in here, but the Replicator 1 was working fine. Well, it's not working fine anymore. I had filament jams in both nozzles, and in the process of fixing it, had to replace the hot end on one, replace the thermal throat on the other, and afterwards, the one, the throat was too tight, and the other one, the thermistor just wasn't reading the temperatures right, and I will get it fixed, but for a little while, old reliable Replicator 1, the 3D printer that I have been with since the beginning of my 3D printing, is getting a bit of a break, and it has been relegated to the shed of misfit 3D printers that I don't use a whole lot right now, and the WeDo is in here. I feel terrible. I feel sad. This is like an old friend that I've had to put out to pasture, but I will fix it. It will be back, and when the new set is built in the shed, which I am working on, it's sad, but at the same time, it needs to happen. So yeah, guys, new printer at the desk, and I'm looking forward to it because it has a built-in webcam, which means we're gonna have more time lapses like the one you saw in this video. So hey, that's actually something to look forward to, so super cool. Thank you very much for watching. Hey, if I mentioned anything in this video, you'll find a link to it in the cards, and you should check that out. Did you know that I'm social? I've got links to all the socials, and you should stop by and say hi. I really kind of enjoy it when that happens. Big thanks go out to my direct backers, and if you want to know more about how you can become that, there'll be a link right here that you can check out. And as always, I want to remind you, safety first, because I care about you, and I'll see you next time. Oh, that's interesting. Classic one there. Quickly clean this mess up. There is no quickly cleaning up pocket tactics.